Trail of Cold Steel is a game that I was really looking for. Since Trail in the Sky the Third came out, the third was good, but it was good because of the battle system being at the peak of its potential, meaning that I still had the thirst for adventure and for an intriguing story and the quality character development that got me hooked on the Trail series in the beginning. Did I got that from Trail of Cold Steel? No! And I must start by pointing out that I might be biased towards that game. In general, when I give my opinion on a game that is part of a series that I love, I tend to be harsher because I keep comparing the game to previous edition in the series that I consider masterpiece. I'm just always like, oh my god, that was better in the first game. And that other thing was better in the second game. Anyway, if you want to know a little bit where I come from on the series, I suggest you to watch my review on Trail in the Sky. Also, I will definitely do a lot of comparison between Trail of Cold Steel and Trail in the Sky in this review, but let's start breaking down the game. The story follows Rin Schrozer, a new student at Thor's Academy. He's part of this new class where commoner and noble are mixed together, which is something that has never been done since the Erebonian Empire functioned with the class system. And if you are a noble, it's expected that you only interact with noble on the first half of every chapter. You get to see Rin and his classmate at the academy, and on the second half, you see them visiting diverse places on their field study. Over time, you get to see Rin and his friend bond with each other. Problem here is that interesting dialogue and cool story are hard under a pile of boring ass quests and monotone conversation, especially at the beginning. Since characters don't know each other, a lot of the exchanges you see in the first chapter are introduction to one of the thousand characters or small talk. What I mean by small talk is the kind of conversation you get with the taxi driver. And the only time you see characters having deeper and more interesting conversation are sometime during field study. One by one, they're gonna slowly show some true color. By the end of the game, it almost feels like you got multi-layer characters with their own personality and their own place in the group. And that's actually the only reason why I think I'm still gonna try Trail of Cold Steel 2, because of the character. Since the overall story and most of the quests are uninteresting at best. Okay, when you are at the academy, you either act as the student council bitch doing various tasks like delivering notebook, doing book delivery, retrieving a notebook, and doing mail delivery. Those are all exciting true quests in the game. Exposing the exciting life of a postman, or maybe what you want in an RPG, is some good quality gameplay at the academy, like studying and doing exam. On the second half of every chapter, you got the field study. You might think that field study are jam-packed with action and you're gonna start fighting epic monster and be on cool adventure. To be fair, there is some of that on field study, but again, you have to go through a lot of tedious quests like cat retrieving, sheep retrieving, cat retrieving again, play hide and seek with kids. Let's be real for a second. Those quests have zero value to the story and are not interesting. Nonetheless, at a certain point, you finally get to see the main issue of the place you are visiting, and with some good character development on the side, when you get to that point, it is so good and it is so fucking short. Like seriously, every single chapter, at a certain point, you get to have some fun. And you get your ass dragged back to the academy to do some stupid ass task that have zero purpose in this fucking game. On time to time, you will get updated by diverse group or character on the event you were part of, and it made me feel like those characters were having all the fun. It is extremely lacking of action and adventure, but talking about action, let's move on to the gameplay. The thing with the gameplay is that it's really sequential. You can fight a couple of monsters, then you have to go through 5 minutes of cutscene and 5 minutes of boring ass whatever. And then between quests, only during field study, you can go explore a little bit around the city. The area next to those cities are pretty linear and there's no map who doesn't touch quests. So if you go through all the quests, you will get to explore those areas and there's nothing more to explore. It's kinda rare to fight enemies that are stronger than the rest, and when you do, they're not that strong and the payoff is not that great. So overall, the game doesn't allow a lot of exploration, which is really sad for a JRPG. I mean, if you compare to Tale of Zestiria, it's not even in the same realm. It's ridiculous. Another thing that annoyed me into oblivion is that they took the Shining Palm, one of the recurring enemy in the Trail game, and they put him as a DLC now. I think it's a money-grabbing dick move. Instead of working on actual new bonus thing for DLC, they took something that they had and now they ask money for it. But it's not all dark for the gameplay. I feel like they introduced a couple of new features that were quite cool. I like the new battle link and they changed the quartz system. I could talk a lot about the link and the master quartz system. I don't want this video to be that long, but let's just say that I like it and move on. Beyond that, the gameplay is still the same as in Trail in the Sky, but in 3D. You got basic attack, you got spell called art, you got combat move called craft, and you got your special called S-craft. Overall, I don't think the game is garbage, but I didn't like it. If I had to give it a note, I would give him 54%. You really want it to pass, but it just doesn't. There's still a chance for Trail of Cold Steel 2 and 3 to be good. I will have to wait for them to come out on Steam to do a review. On this note, have a nice day. See ya.